your skin, Big Bandage.
Hello, beauties. My name is Daisy. I am the CEO and founder of Banish. Today, I wanted to talk to you guys about something very vulnerable, and I'm not actually even sure if I'm going to end up posting this video, but why I don't like the skincare, or why I just don't like skincare anymore. And this is really weird saying it because I have been working on Banish for over 7 years, still doing it, still growing, still loving it, still thriving. But it's weird because 7 years later, I don't know, I realized that skincare might not be, I have a lot of mixed feelings about skincare. You probably know my story, I'll reiterate it for those who are new to this channel, but I've had acne my entire life, and I always thought when I was younger that fixing my skin was going to be a solution for all the problems and the insecurities I had. So acne was almost like my scapegoat, and acne prevented me from doing what I wanted to do, being who I truly was. I never thought I was pretty. I always thought I was like the ugly duckling in a group. I never really had any friends, and it was because I told myself I was ugly, and it was because I told myself I had acne and I didn't look like everyone else. And while starting Banish, it was so great to find a solution for my skin and also to help other people feel confident about themselves. Because the one thing I say, in order to improve your confidence and in order to forget about anything that you're going through, whether it's a depression or if you don't feel good about yourself, is to simply help other people and provide value for other people. And if you can focus on helping other people, you realize that your own vanity, your own insecurities, it doesn't matter because nobody cares about that. People, you know, you offer so much more value to the world than the way you look. So that has been really gratifying and one of my, I would say probably the most fulfilling part of running Banish. I have been watching a lot of skincare YouTube channels, and there's so many of them, and they have hundreds, if not thousands of videos reviewing skincare products. And to me, people ask like, why don't we have more products at Banish? Why don't we launch more products, expand our line, go into other verticals, whatnot? And honestly, for me, creating more products is not what is most fulfilling for me, to me. Because as I watch these skincare videos, it's so weird how, you know, these skincare reviewers are picking apart every tiny little thing about a product, and there's so much content about, is this product better than this product, or is that product better than this product? And at the end of the day, what are we chasing for? What are we trying to achieve with these skincare products? Why are we spending so much money on skincare, and why are we watching hundreds of videos about vitamin C serums? You know, it's really about this sense of achieving perfection with our skin. It's a sense of thinking that the more skincare products we will have or try, we're gonna somehow stumble upon a magic solution that's going to fix our skin and erase all of our problems. And I watch these channels, and these are very dedicated skincare channels, and I think, will it ever end? Of course, it's gonna be a journey, not a destination. But how many products can you review and try and do all this? Do you get burnt out? And I also look at sometimes people's faces and stuff like that, and I see that, you know, they'll get plastic surgery or in injections or whatnot. And again, do what makes you happy, but there's this never ending sense for perfection. No matter how many facial treatments you try, no matter how many skincare products you buy, no matter what you do to your face or how you change your diet or whatnot, there's always more, right, for your skin. And even in the past year, I have thought, while I feel very, very good at what I do, and while Banish, we have a bigger mission than just to, you know, change your skin and make your skin better, I sometimes don't feel like what I'm doing is that fulfilling, to be honest, because I'm not, I don't know, an oncologist, I'm not a social worker, I'm not a teacher, I'm not, I don't know, I feel like, am I promoting the standard of perfection to people? Am I promoting this impossible beauty standard? Am I part of the bigger problem? Am I spending all of my hard-earned time and money and my team's Are we contributing to this bigger problem out there? And could I do something like be a cancer researcher and actually do something that makes it like an actual difference in people's lives? Am I talking about the different, I mean, even talking about the different forms of vitamin C? Yes, I know it and I'm very good at it and like it's needed, but is it fulfilling? Is it gonna change someone's life, you know? In the bigger scheme of things, probably not. So that's why even on this channel, the best performing videos on this channel have always been about acne, have always been about skincare. And while it was fun for the first, you know, few years of doing it, I'm 31 years old now and it's not fulfilling to review a billion different products and tell you guys all the slight nuances about them and, I don't know, somehow perpetuate this myth that the more that these products will change your life and these products will completely change your skin. And I even say that for Banish. You know, our products are really, really good and I can stand behind them and they've been doing super well because we've been in business for 7 years and we haven't raised any money. It just keeps growing and stuff like that. But I'm not gonna say that just buying Banish products is going to change your life. It's not. Only you can change your life, right? And yes, even if it helps you with your skin, even if it helps you become more confident, even if it clears up your skin, at the end of the day, you still have who you are. And at the end of the day, you cannot escape yourself. And I guess I've been tired about the skincare industry trying to push out more products because the more products you push out, the more money you're gonna make, right? Because everyone wants a new launch, everybody wants a new palette, everybody wants a new this, this, that. And it, yes, the sales will go up for a short amount of time, but is the mission of your company, are you really helping that much more people? Are you inspiring confidence in them, right? That to me is what is most fulfilling, not just launching things and seeing the sales go up and all of that stuff. So I guess I've been burnt out by the skincare industry, to be honest, because of this never-ending quest to make your skin perfect. And being almost 9 months pregnant now, my skin has undergone a lot of changes. My body has undergone a lot of changes. And I have not panicked and I have not tried to do things to minimize the effect pregnancy will have on my physical appearance. So I have gained, you know, a significant amount of weight, probably more than I would like to admit. My skin is also not at its best because I'm not eating well and just because of the hormone fluctuations. And I think the old me, the old Daisy, would have tried so hard to keep it under control and I probably would be a lot healthier because I didn't want to gain the weight and I'd be obsessive about the way I looked. And now I simply don't care. You know, I don't really care that much because I am who I am and I have valued myself so much more than on the way I looked. You know, in my 20s, yes, I was so concerned about how I looked to people, making sure that everything was perfect. And now in my 30s, I honestly don't really give a shit because I'm tired. You know, I'm tired. I want to develop meaning in my life, and my meaning is not to perpetuate the standard of perfection in the beauty industry. So yeah, that's why I've been burnt out by skincare. Now that's not going to say that we're not gonna launch new products at Banish. We always are looking and testing new stuff and brainstorming ideas and trying to listen to your feedback, but I'm saying we're not gonna just launch a product just to launch a product, basically, you know? I know companies, they will launch new products every season, every whatever, and for us, it's not, you know, we're not gonna force it if we don't come upon something that we really, truly love. And that's why also Banish, we don't even have 10 products, you guys. Probably have 6 or 7 products. And yes, I'm sure we could triple that, but to me, it's not fulfilling. To me, it's not fulfilling to give you guys more stuff that you need to buy or just more stuff to make your skin more perfect, because the reality is it's never going to be perfect. I see a lot of people in this industry and I see how their faces have changed. And to me, it's really sad, honestly. Really sad, this obsession with beauty and skincare. It honestly makes me feel very empty. It doesn't create any meaning to my life. Even if we could make so much more money by being part of this industry, it's not fun for me. On the other side of it, on the business side of it, skincare is a very competitive industry. And yes, a lot of it is marketing. I mean, with any consumer product, I mean, most of it is marketing, right? And to kind of hear people bash one product versus another, I think over time, you get tired of it, right? You get tired of it. Because I only know that my skin is not going to be as good as what's yesterday. no matter how much Banish I put on my face, no matter how many procedures I undergo, my skin will never be as good as it is today, because I'm only getting older and there's more, you know, stuff going in it, and I can't fight this. You know, I can't fight this struggle. And I see people's faces changing and people, you know, going under the knife and getting all these things done and fillers and all of that. And to me, it's really a symptom of fear of maybe the aging process, a fear of getting older, a fear of getting further and further away from that ideal standard. And it makes me sad that people are feeling this way. And it makes me sad that we have so much content about skincare, this quest for perfection, but we don't really take the time to work on ourselves and internally what's most important. So as my mission, as being the CEO of the company, I really want to focus on helping people be the best version of themselves. That to me is so much more important than giving you a bottle of what seems like a bottle of perfection, you know? And that's why I love doing YouTube, and I know my YouTube channel, it seems like it's dying, whatever that means. I still make YouTube videos, you guys. I'm making them when I'm 8.5 months pregnant. I don't make really any money from these videos. My time is very valuable, but I still take time to do this because I truly love it. You know, I truly, truly enjoy it, and I'll keep doing it even if only one or two people view each video, because I love sharing my story and I love sharing how I feel about things, and I love giving you the honest opinion about what I think about things. And I know for a fact that if I focused more on skincare, if I focused more on product reviews, if I focus on reactions to people's skincare routines, blah blah blah, I know my channel would be so much more successful and I would be so much of a better influencer or whatever. But that to me is not fulfilling. It's not, I don't care. I mean, it's like going through the motions of something, right? And then there's the question of becoming an influencer. And I honestly do not want to be an influencer. I want to be who I am. I don't want to be that well known, because I feel like the more well known you get, the more manufactured you become, the more pressure it is to become manufactured. But I want to just be able to speak my truth, whatever that might be, and either you love it or you hate it or you don't care, that's fine. But I think it's really important for me to be able to be real, be authentic, and in turn help other people be their best. I find that the most satisfying feelings I have had has been impact. I think that's what motivates me. I like to have impact. I like to see that our efforts and the fruits of our labor, you know, go somewhere. I love creative freedom, and I love really understanding people. I love learning about them and like figuring out people and just people's stories in general. But I've never, you know, aspired to be famous or to be wildly financially successful, or, you know, to create the number one skincare line that has a bajillion different products. That has never ever been my intention. So this is kind of a long ramble of how I truly feel about the skincare industry and, you know, this phase I'm going through. But don't worry, I'm still here, and I love Banish with all my heart, and we're still going to go and create new products and do the best job we can to help each and every single one of you, not only with your skin, but also more importantly with your self-confidence. But it's just not going to be in the way that maybe other skincare lines do it, or other people in the skincare industry do it, and that's okay. So thank you all so much for watching, and thank you for listening to this rant that was all over the place. I actually wrote it on my phone how I was going to talk about it, but I always go off script. So I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.